I'm Carly McAvoy, and we're talking about linear equations. There's been a couple of videos already talking about the basics, and we're on to using two steps. And sometimes it even takes a little more than two steps to do a few of these. But let's review the one-step equations, and that was, what do you do when you have an equation, which means we have an equal sign in it, and we want to get that by a variable by itself. We get rid of the number that's over there with it. We don't want to move negative 15 because n we want to be alone, and this is the number over here that we want to get rid of. To get rid of something that's being added or subtracted, we do the opposite of the number. So minus 7, we are going to add 7. We're going to add 7 to both sides, and the 7's then cancel, and we get n equals negative 15 and positive 7, which is negative 8. Now you have to talk to your instructor about their calculator use. These kind of things, it'd be nice if you could do those without a calculator. I don't just tell you can't use a calculator for that, but we could see that there's more negatives and there's actually 8 more negatives when you get down to it. So talk to your instructor and make sure you know what the calculator policy is for your tests, so you can be practicing the way you'll be testing. And remember, we were moving towards being able to do those things in our head. So now we have a check, negative 7 plus, we've decided n is negative 8 equals negative 15. And so negative 7 and negative 8 is negative 15. This is how we decide what a solution to an equation is. We're just plugging it in and seeing, does it actually make it true? And if so, then we've checked that equation. We also talked about the multiplication property of equality. If p is being divided by 3, we don't do the opposite of 3. We do the opposite operation here, which division is opposite of multiplication. So we're going to multiply both sides by 3. Remember, I can write 3 as 3 over 1 or just 3. It means the same. But here it's nice to put 3 over 1 so I can see those 3's cancel out. They don't cancel to 0. They cancel to 1. And then I have p, which I always want a coefficient of 1. In other words, nothing with the p, but just a 1, which we don't see, but we understand that it's there. 3 times negative 5 is negative 15. So that's the review of the old types. And now let's look at some equations where we have to do more than one step. So in the old types, we had just one variable on one side, but you could have an equation where you have a variable on both sides. And so what you want to do first, and there's actually more than one way to start, but I'm going to use a method that works for me, and I'm going to be consistent in that, but if you have another method that works for you, that's fine. If you're getting the wrong answer, then please use my method. So I want to get the x's on one side. It doesn't matter which side you put them on. But let's say I don't want x's over here on the right. I want my x's on the left. So I would say, okay, I have a positive x. I know it's positive because there's no negative in front of it. So I'm going to do the opposite, and that is subtract x. Remember, you can only subtract terms that are like terms. And like terms have the same variable to the same power. So I have to line up the x not with the 5, but with the negative x. Remember, we have a scale that we're keeping balanced, so we have to do the same thing to both sides. If I have two x's and I take one x away, that leaves x. I still have this plus 5. That hasn't gone anywhere. And x minus x, well, those are additive inverses. And so when you add opposites, you get 0. So those are gone. I don't need to write 0 in there. And what I have left is negative 3. Notice that I don't drop that minus sign because that's part of that term. And now that's one step, but now I'm not done. I have to do what I did up here, and that is, how do I get x by itself? Well, you get x by itself by getting rid of the constant by doing the opposite. Since it's plus 5, we're going to subtract 5, and I'm going to subtract 5 on both sides. And those are 0, so they go away. And x equals negative 3 and negative 5 together make negative 8. So I think it's negative 8, and of course, we can check that because we have the ability. 2 times negative 8 plus 5 should be equal to negative 8 minus 3. Well, 2 times negative 8 is negative 16 plus 5, and negative 8 minus negative or minus 3 is negative 11. Negative 16 and positive 5, I've got more negatives by 11, so negative 11 equals negative 11, and it's checked. I always check my equations when I'm not sure, and you should check them because you should not be sure just starting off on this journey. You should be checking them all yourself. Now, number 4 is different than the last one. See how I had x's on both sides, variable on both sides? I only have variables on the left side, and it's important to you to realize when do you do the opposite and when do you not do the opposite. So people will say, well, sometimes you do the opposite and sometimes you don't. If they're on the same side of the equation, then you don't do the opposite. You do exactly what you see. You have 5y's and you're subtracting 4y's. You look at the term in the sign in front of it. So if you have 5 and you take away 4, you have 1y left. And that just simplifies your equation down. We didn't do the opposite because they were together on the same side. Only if we're trying to balance a scale that have things on both sides do we need to do the same thing on both sides. This one, we're just simplifying. Now I want to get that y by itself. And since I have a minus 7, I'm going to add 7 to both sides. And those become 0, and I get y equals 10. Y equals 10, I think, is the answer. I can go back here and check it. 5 times 10 minus 7 minus 4 times 10 should be 3. Well, that's 50 minus 7 minus 40. 50 minus 7 is 43. 43, excuse me, minus 40 is 3. That's it. I got it right. So those are two steps. Both of these are different, so I'm showing you several different types, so whatever you encounter, you've got an example for. Of course, you want to write these problems down, try them yourself, pause the video, come back and see. Let's move on because it's going to get too long here for my video. In this particular problem, it's similar to what I had. It looks like similar because I have the variable on both sides like I did up here. Since they're on both sides, I need to do the same to both sides. I need to get rid of this and move it to the other side, rid of this 3z term. This is a positive 3z, so I'm going to subtract 3z from both sides. 14z minus 3z is 11z. Now these are opposites, they're gone, and I end up with 33. And I want to divide both sides by 11 because that's the coefficient, and I'm always trying to make my coefficient be 1, even though I don't write the 1 in there. And so that's it, and I can check that. 14 times 11 is 3 times 11 plus 33. Well, that's going to be 154 equals, wait a minute, that doesn't look right. 14 is 3. I don't know what I did there. 30. 42. You know what's good is that sometimes your check is wrong. Your work is right, but you check it wrong. I just plugged in 11 instead of 3, which was the answer. But notice I was like, wait, that can't be right. There's something wrong. 3 times 3 is 9 plus 33 is 42. You know what's really nice is if you're watching the video and you catch my mistake before I do. So when you saw me doing that check, you're like, why is she putting 11 in there? 11 wasn't the answer. Hopefully you saw that. And you can start to feel good, like you're getting enough to know when somebody else's mind's going away, which is kind of what was happening to me. Okay, t on both sides. This is just like the last one. It'd be great to pause the video and try it on your own. Follow that example over there. I want to get rid of this 3t, and so it's positive 3t, so I subtract 3t. If I have 6 and I take away 3, I've got 3 left. And then I want to divide both sides by the coefficient, which is 3. It's the number next to the variable. And that cancels out to 1, and t equals negative 3. So I think the answer is negative 3, and of course I can check that. 6 times negative 3 is equal to 3 times negative 3 minus 9. Whoops, got off the edge there a little bit. Let's move it over. That should be negative 18, and that's negative 9 minus 9, and negative 18 equals negative 18 checks out. So perfect, we did it. Let's look at the last four quickly. I've only got a few minutes to make this work. I'm trying to get these videos a little shorter than I'm used to. Here I have this 7q and I have a 2. So it's important to note that you need to think about alphabetically the addition property of equality and then the multiplication property of equality. I'm always going to get rid of my constant term first. You get rid of that by doing the opposite. Minus 2, you're going to add 2. 12 plus 2 is 14. And then you're going to get rid of that coefficient by dividing both sides by 7. If you divide both sides by 7, then those cancel out to 1 and Q equals 2. I can check that 7 times 2 minus 2 should be 12. 14 minus 2 is 12. So I get the same thing on both sides and it checks out. What's different about this problem? Well, now that problem, notice we had to use the addition property and then the multiplication property. And we did it up here too. We used the addition property and then the multiplication. So we've been using both of those. But in addition, number 8, we have to get rid of parentheses. We need to clean up this side. We're not even worried about the fact that it's an equation or what's on the other side. We're just getting rid of parentheses. And so we multiply 3 times x. This is a distributive property. And 3 times 2. There's a minus sign in there. Now you're back to the same thing we just had. Try that without me and then see if you get it right. Come back in a minute. I'm going to get rid of the minus 6 by adding 6. And then I'm going to get rid of the coefficient by dividing by 3. I try to remind you that your answers don't always come out to be these lovely little integers or what you like. Even that's just a weird fraction, right? Doesn't mean I can't check it. I'm going to say 3 times 14 thirds. Now 2 is as a third would be 6, right? Because negative 2 over 1, if I wanted to change that into having a 3 on the bottom, I'd multiply by 3 and I'd get negative 6 thirds. So I'm going to do that. Again, not about fractions right now, so if you're having trouble with that, go check out some fraction videos. So now I'm going to say 14 minus 6 is 8, so I have 8 thirds. And then if I think about multiplying these, the 3's go away, and 8 equals 8. So 14 thirds checks out. And it's a really nice use of your calculator to see if you can plug that right into a calculator and make it work. I'll show you the use of a calculator later. Okay, let's take a look at our two last problems, 9 and 10. We want to get the variables together. So I have a minus 2y, so I'm going to add 2y. I've just been putting my variables on the left side, and I kind of probably will. And if you do it differently, that's okay. Negative 3y and positive 2 is negative 1y. You can write the 1 or not. But over here, these are opposites, and they go away, leaving minus 4. Don't forget, really important to bring your sign down with it. Now we want to get y by itself. We've got a negative, and we have a 6. Remember, it's always the addition property and then the multiplication property. When you have an option, do the addition first. That is, get rid of your constant term. Since you have a plus 6, you're going to subtract 6. And then, then you have to get rid of the coefficient. We have a coefficient of negative 1, even though we don't see it. It's negative 1. We have to get rid of that just like any other term. So we're going to divide both sides by negative 1. And the two negatives make a positive. And these two negatives make a positive. So we get y equals 10. I'm not going to check that one because I'm almost out of time. Let's jump over here to this one. Yes, you can see a fraction. But no, it doesn't change anything. The fractions still operate the same. So I'm going to get rid of the constant term by adding 1/3 to both sides. Again, I'm not here to teach you how to do fractions. Use your calculator if you would like. But I will tell you that I have to find a common denominator here. The minus 1/3 and plus 1/3 goes away. What I have is 5/6. And then if I make this a 6 by multiplying by 2, I get 2/6. So I have 5/6 and 2/6, which is 7/6. And then I want to get rid of that 2. Remember, I'm always doing the multiplication property after I've taken care of the addition property. Addition includes subtraction, and multiplication includes division, but those are what we call those properties. Since I'm dividing r by 2, I'm going to multiply both sides by 2. That makes those 2's go away. They go away to 1, not to 0. And r equals, well, 2 goes into 6 3 times, so I can cross-cancel that, right? And I would get 7, 1 times 7 on the top, and 3 times 1 on the bottom. And 7/3 is my answer. If you didn't cross-cancel, and you said 7, 6 times 2 over 1 is 14 over 6, you would still have to reduce that. Because you can't leave an answer like this is not, this is an improper fraction, but it's simplified. There's no factors that are in common on the numerator and denominator. This is an improper fraction that's not simplified. Improper fractions are okay, but you have to make sure they're reduced to lowest terms or simplified. Okay, I'm out of time. Have a great day. I'll see you.